Thank you. Yo.
Hi.
How you doing?
Yes, I'm just waiting for BCE.
Are you?
The car is fine, but up the hill, front wheel drive.
All right, so you're good then?
Yep, all good. Thank you.
Alternating until 5 p.m. today. Sierra and Savings Events is on now at Chevrolet until January 1st. Get an additional $500 off new lease bonus on select 2020 and 2021 models. This is ChevroletOffers.ca. In the M730 Traffic Center, I'm Amber Belzer.
Coming off the Barnett Highway, there was a collision. This one, Barnett to eastbound just past Ioco. So it's backed up to Dundee Trunk Road. So this over into Coquitlam there. Looks like it is still there. It's backed up to Dundee Trunk Road. Busy stuff there. Iron Workers, boy, it had been a decent rush, but with this stall on the bridge now, southbound middle lane blocked, it is brutal. Highway 1 east is backed almost solid to Westview. The Lions Gate's not bad, though. It's still 2 north, 1 south, but not a super long lineup out in Arthur West Van. And Alex Fraser, right lane blocked both ways due to that winter-related maintenance. Use the Massey Tunnel. At least southbound Massey Tunnel's wide open with Counterflow doing its job. 99 north busy from 17A.
This is CHMJ, AM 730.
Northbound. westbound, you're backed up from the south end, and then the winter conditions causing delays for eastbound 64th, eastbound 72nd, and Nordell really between about 112th and 116th, the reported problems aside from the weather. Now in Langley, 16th Avenue having great difficulty on both sides of 200. We have multiple vehicles stuck on the hills there blocking traffic. There's going to be a lot of extra volume for the Campbell Heights area, 192nd, 32nd, 176 northbound to Highway 10 jamming up. Fraser Highway heavy, Highway 1 east and westbound heavy. No reported problems, but you're heavy from about Glover straight through to east of 264th, and then westbound is slow from about Bradner to 64th, and again, all the feeder routes jammed up as well. Looking for updates out of town, and Highway 5 still blocked off for any traffic trying to get past Over Merritt. If you were stuck past that point, you were able to get behind the plows and start moving again, and traffic seems to between that Highway 3 is now blocked off as well between Hope and Princeton due to heavy snowfall. Traffic for Trail Appliances needs a rush. Trail Appliances Boxing Week preview is on now. Get Boxing Week prices early at your favorite brand, any of the 12 locations, or online at trailappliances.com. Now for the Ben Folds Roofing and Solar Weather Center, here's weather specialist Michelle Yee.
We are starting to see the showers tapering off through the North Shore. We are seeing rain through Burnaby and New West, but it turns back into that wet snow as you're heading into Surrey, and it is snow as you pass Langley and all the way out through Abbotsford. Now this snow will turn into rain. We are going to see the rain taking us into the evening hours before it wraps up. Overnight, it is going to be cool, a low just zero with a clear sky, but tomorrow, back to sunshine with daytime highs hitting 5 degrees. Currently in Langley, we are seeing that snow piling up, and we're sitting at 1 degree.
News 11:30 time, 4:04. To our top story this hour, BC has recorded more than 1,600 new cases of COVID-19. The total of 1,667 comes over the last 3 days. Meanwhile, the virus has resulted in another 41 deaths. 283 of those new cases are in the Vancouver Coastal Health Region, and more than 1,000 are in Fraser Health. Dr. Bonnie Henry says last week, more than 3,600 people, mostly healthcare workers, were vaccinated here in the Lower Mainland.
And today, I can confirm that the vaccine deliveries have arrived in every health authority in British Columbia. As we saw last week in Vancouver and in Fraser Health, teams in the other health regions are preparing, even as we speak, to get immunization clinics underway in the coming days.
Other numbers, 341 people currently in the hospital in BC. That includes 80 in the ICU, and there are more than 9,700 active cases in this province. This is happening now. It's snowing in some parts of the Lower Mainland. Frightening moments as well for a woman driving across the Portman Bridge. She tells us ice bombs have badly damaged her windshield. Ravinder Bassi says she's shocked.
It was just so frightening that this happened, like all of a sudden as I was just driving. Didn't even expect it because it's not snowing that hard out here. It's like a mix of more so of rain, not even that much snow. So I didn't even expect it. It was pretty frightening.
Police had shut down westbound traffic across the Portman because of this, but it appears drivers are now getting through due to similar situations. In recent years, the province had installed a snow clearing collar system to reduce the chances of ice buildup. Now, most of the snow we're seeing today is expected in the Fraser Valley, but some flurries have been going on here in Metro Vancouver. Darren L. with Main Road says his crews draw upon seasoned staff to make sure they respond to the best of their ability.
So we're all...
192nd, all very heavy there in that South Langley, South Surrey, Campbell Heights stretch. And also looking for updates, Port Moody had a crash in Barnett eastbound East Oyoka Road, and in Surrey, a jackknife bus on Fraser Highway westbound at 168. That is volume backed up towards about 176. If you see any other problems, star 1130. Traffic from My Garage Hope, now selling and leasing state-of-the-art storage units big enough for both RVs and more. Visit MyGarageHope.com for more information. Now for the Penfold Roofing and Solar Weather Center, here is weather specialist Michelle Yee.
The wind does remain light coming out of the airport, but the wind warning is still on for Richmond and South Delta, with those wind gusts expected to hit up to 90 kilometers an hour through the evening hours. We are seeing rain for the rest of Metro Vancouver. If you're heading through Surrey and into the valley, we do have snow still. It is going to turn to rain as we head into the evening hours, and it wraps up overnight, and we are looking at a low of zero. Currently in Surrey, it's wet snow sitting at zero, but in Burnaby, we do see rain and sitting at 3 degrees.
We're just a few minutes away from sunset here in Vancouver, and we're just about 1 hour away from kickoff in Monday Night Football. Adam will bring us a preview coming up in sports.
is in sight there. So upper levels, you're solid from Westview right down the cut and about halfway across the bridge. And low level road, expect equal backups there. But somehow, the Alex Fraser, or I should say the elect Alex Fraser, wouldn't that be something? The Landgate Bridge looks pretty good. Southbound there on the westbound side, you're back to Taylor Way. And North Vancouver, even quieter, just busy inside the loop. Now, for the Alex Fraser Bridge, taking a note from Darren there, you're going to find the volume still heavy from west of Westminster Highway, that Graybar stretch. There's a lane closure in both directions for winter maintenance, so very heavy just for that. No crashes. Northbound flow from the south end. Eastbound 64th, 72nd, even Nordell between 112th and 116th, heavy for those conditions and volume. Massey Tunnel not bad, the usual there. Now, South Surrey Langley, a big delay because of multiple trucks stuck on 16th Avenue on both sides of 200 there because of hills and winter conditions. So the ripple effect all through the Campbell Heights area, 32nd, 24th, 192nd. Fraser Highway, you're heading pretty much from about 232nd straight through until east of 264th, even all the way towards Mount Lehman. That's just volume, a lot of people skipping Highway 1, worried about the conditions and crashes. And you're just heavy, no crashes that I'm aware of. You're slow eastbound from Glover to east of 264th and westbound from about, looks like Bradner to east of 260, or west of 264th there. Now, Port Moody, there's a crash, Barnett Highway eastbound east of Ioco Road. And good news out of Surrey, clear of the bus that was stalled on Fraser Highway westbound at 168, thus moving at a better pace. A couple things of note here, looking for updates on the Coquihalla.
With their summer tires on.